Can you remember a time in your life when you hedged your bets against some uncertainty? As a student, maybe you applied to multiple schools in the hopes of getting just one acceptance letter. Or maybe you bought insurance for your car or home as protection against the worst-case scenario. Or maybe you've packed a raincoat or an umbrella on a perfectly sunny day, just in case. When a young trader named William Sublette decided to establish a trading post near the Laramie River in 1834, he too was hedging his bets. Sublette recognized that, at the time, trade in beaver fur was in steep decline, while buffalo hides were increasingly in demand. Sublette strategically established Fort William, the precursor to Fort Laramie, in eastern Wyoming, which allowed him to trade with both fur trappers from the mountains and hide hunters from the Great Plains. And in laying out Fort William, Sublette further hedged his bets. He set the fort close enough to the Laramie River to provide a dependable source of water, but far enough from the banks to guard against periodic floods. And in constructing the fort, Sublette built a network of blockhouses, passageways, gates, and rooftop promenades from which occupants could defend against any possible hostilities. By taking stock of trends and planning for the realities of the time and place, Sublette and others helped secure the viability of Fort Laramie as a trading post, military installation, homestead, and ultimately, a national park for the next 180 years. Today, climate change presents new challenges to the preservation of Fort Laramie. Projections suggest that in the years ahead, the region is going to see rising temperatures and changing precipitation patterns that will result in even drier conditions and more days of extreme heat. At the same time, the frequency and magnitude of intense rainfall events is also likely to increase. Combined, these factors will bring a greater risk of flooding on the Laramie River. Increases in flood frequency and intensity can cause severe erosion and damage or destroy historic artifacts and structures along the riverbank. In fact, the park has already experienced unprecedented flooding in recent years. The good news is that projections are not necessarily predictions. We can temper the worst effects of climate change through our present efforts to slow rates of deforestation, save energy, and reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Still, temperatures are already warming, and some degree of change will be inevitable. Though we may not know with certainty what might happen or when, we can take precautions to help guard against the worst. We do this every day in our personal lives, from getting dental checkups, to diversifying our investments, to putting on sunscreen. So, like the young trader William Sublette, we can take stock of the trends, plan for our future, and help ensure Fort Laramie National Historic Site survives another 180 years. The question is, what action should we be taking today to hedge our bets against a changing climate tomorrow? Can you picture it?